So let's have a look at what's happening here from a neuroscience perspective. It's called the perception-action cycle. Whenever we're tasked with solving a problem, and in this case the problem is how to get a penguin across a screen, we use our existing schema, literally neural networks, ideas we've already built. We use these to make a prediction. Here's what I think will happen. So then I take an action, in this case the moves in the game, and then Gigi takes over and animates out the consequences of my choices. Notice we get to see exactly why we got this right. So I perceive the outcome, and inside the brain, in the hippocampus, a little part right in the middle, something very remarkable happens. The prediction I made is compared to my perception. Here's what I thought would happen versus here's what's actually happened. And because I was correct, they match. And the schema that caused me to make that prediction is strengthened. Literally, chemicals flood from the hippocampus to that neural network and make it bigger and stronger. So the next time I see a similar problem, it's more likely that this schema will make my prediction. This is how we build conceptual understanding. Schema, like spatial reasoning, proportional reasoning, numeracy, and so on. But learning doesn't just happen when you get things right. Let's rewind and look at another possibility. Imagine a different schema fired up, causing us to make a different prediction and choose a different set of moves. The game still animates out, but this time Gigi does not get across the screen. Notice, again, I get to see precisely why I was wrong. I perceive the outcome, and in the hippocampus, my perception is compared to my prediction, but this time they do not match. First, the hippocampus sends a signal that deprioritizes that schema. So the next time I see a problem like this, that schema is much less likely to influence my thinking. This is how misconceptions are rectified. But very importantly, a second signal is also emitted from the hippocampus, theta waves, that tell the brain you need to learn something new. You need to build new schema. The work of people like Joe Bowler, the idea that students learn through their mistakes, is very accurate and based upon this fundamental neuroscience. And this is what happens in every single ST Math puzzle. And to complete a single grade level of ST Math, students will solve several thousand puzzles. That's a lot of learning by doing.